Pop music is short for popular music and is very easy to recognise. Now, many musical historians would say that popular music is music that was popular at that time. So the exact date that pop music started is debatable. Now, we'll start with the 1960s. Now, many pop groups were emerging and it was very common to see lots of teenagers packing out concert halls to see bands such as the Californian group The Beach Boys and the Liverpudlian band The Beatles. In fact, there were a lot of British bands such as The Animals and Herman's Hermits that were dominating the US charts. This was known as the British Invasion. Now, the instruments used in pop music were also starting to develop. Acoustic and electric guitars, bass guitar, piano, keyboard, synthesizers, that's the electronic sounding keyboard that you get, lead vocals and backing vocals. Now, Beatlemania was huge. In 1965, the Beatles played their first stadium gig at the Shea Stadium in New York City, which was groundbreaking. Around 55,000 screaming fans filled the stadium, with thousands more queuing outside just to get a glimpse of the band. The speakers at the time were very small and very basic, so much so you couldn't really hear the band, especially with the constant drone of screaming fans. It was impossible to hear what was happening. However, most didn't mind at the time, they just wanted to see the band. Now, pop music in the 1970s appeared in the form of disco, so check out the Tramps, and there's lots of other bands associated with disco. The 1980s saw synth pop take the UK by storm. Check out the Human League and Aha, great bands. However, in the 90s, the 1990s that is, boy bands and girl bands were huge. I'm sure you've all heard of the Spice Girls and the Backstreet Boys. This music had a simple structure to it, making it easy to listen to. Now, we don't have enough time to talk about all the pop artists from before then and from the year 2000 onwards. It's just that big. However, there are many features that can be heard in pop music, and here they come. Feature number one, verse and chorus. Now, this is usually to do with the lyrics and the song structure. Okay, so there might be different verses in a song. The verses are usually there to set up the story, and it is usually followed by a chorus. Okay, the chorus is usually the part that everyone remembers, and it tends to be very repetitive and catchy. Now, the chorus lyrics don't usually change, but the lyrics and the verses do usually change. Feature number two, riff. Now, I'm sure you've heard this word in many styles. The riff is just a repeating pattern, usually on a guitar, but can also be a keyboard, okay, a melodic instrument. And it's usually quite catchy and repetitive. Feature number three, ostinato. Again, a word that you've probably heard before, but this is just a general term used for a repeating pattern on any instrument, but it's usually used to describe the drums or the percussion, the song. So, let's take a look at these features in action. This song is called A Thousand Miles and it's by Vanessa Carlton, and that's her starting off with a riff there. Straight into verse one. So this is her setting out the story. And this riff, this piano riff, keeps coming back. So beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Finishing off the verse. Still in the verse. And back to the riff again. Now here's the ostinato. Played on the drum kit. Have a little listen. It's just a repeating pattern. It does vary throughout the piece as we go into different sections, but for each section you can hear an ostinato on the drum kit and some percussion. Have a little listen. And I need you, and I miss you, and now I wonder if I could fall to the sky. Do you think time went past me by? 'Cause you know I'd walk a thousand miles if I can just see you tonight. Now we're back to the riff again, and we're shortly about to start verse two. There's always times like these when I think of you, and I wonder if you ever think of me.
need you, and I miss you. Now I wonder if I could fall into the sky. Do you think time went past me by?
Thanks for listening. That was Vanessa Carlton, 1,000 Miles. That was out when I was your age at school.